Hello friends, welcome to TextIDCell. In this video, we'll make a simple LoRa project to control the appliances and also monitor the real-time feedback from a distance up to 5 to 10 km without using any Wi-Fi and Bluetooth signal. And I will also share the circuit diagram, code and all other required information. So I will highly recommend you to watch the complete video, and after watching this video, you can easily make this project in your home. Now here you can see this is the transmitter circuit, and this LoRa module is connected with the Arduino Nano, and with this push button I can control these lamps connected with the relay module, and with this LED I can monitor the real-time feedback. Now in the receiving LoRa circuit I have used NodeMCU, but you can use any microcontroller instead of NodeMCU, and although I have used PCB to avoid any loose connection. But you can also use a relay module and NodeMCU to make this receiving LoRa circuit. Now I have already given the supply. You can use a 9 volt battery for this transmitter circuit. Now if I press the first push button, you can see this yellow LED is blinking, which indicates it's sending the signal. After it received the signal, the lamp turns on, and it also sends the feedback to the transmitter circuit, and after receiving the feedback the green LED will turn on. Now if I press the second button, again this LED is blinking, second lamp turns on and it will receive the feedback, and after receiving it the green LED will turn on. Now if I remove the wire from the TX pin of the LoRa module, then this Arduino cannot receive the feedback from the receiving circuit. So let me press the third button, and again you can see the third lamp turns on, but it cannot receive the feedback. And if the feedback not received, then this red LED will turn on. Now let me connect the wire with the TX pin of the LoRa module again. Now if I press the fourth button, and again the fourth lamp turns on and it received the feedback, and green LED turn on. Now to turn off these lamps, I have to press the buttons again. So if I press the first button again, it will change the state of the lamp and it will send a feedback, and again you can see the green LED turns on. Now let me show you how I have made this project. So without any further delay, let's get started. In this video I will use this RYLR896 LoRa module from REYAX. You can easily control this LoRa module with some basic AT command, which you will see during the video. Then you need an Arduino, some LEDs, push buttons, a 220 ohm resistor, 4.7 kilo ohm resistor and 10 kilo ohm resistor. So these are the components for the transmitter LoRa circuit. And for the receiving LoRa circuit, again you need another LoRa module, a microcontroller, here I am using NodeMCU, relay module to control the appliances, and a 4.7 kilo ohm and 10 kilo ohm resistor. This is a transmitter LoRa circuit. Here you can see I have connected this LoRa module with the Arduino, and these two resistors will act as a voltage divider to drop down the 5 volt logic level from Arduino to 3.3 volt. In my previous video, I have already explained how you can connect the Arduino with the LoRa module and why this voltage divider is required. I will share the video link in the description. Now these LEDs are used to monitor the feedback from the receiving end, and these are the push button connected with the Arduino. So when you press any push button, the Arduino send the related signal to the receiving end through this LoRa module. Now this is the receiving end circuit, and this LoRa module will receive that signal sent by the transmitter circuit and send the signal to NodeMCU. Now NodeMCU will process that signal and accordingly turn on and off any relays and send the feedback to transmitter circuit through this LoRa module. Now in this circuit I have also used this voltage divider to drop down 5 volt logic level to 3.3 volt. Now for this circuit you can also use any other microcontroller instead of NodeMCU. And while making this circuit, please make sure there should not be any loose connection, otherwise this circuit may not work. This is the transmitter LoRa circuit. I have made the complete circuit on the breadboard. These are the push buttons and LEDs connected with the Arduino. And for the receiving end, as I said, you can use a relay module and NodeMCU, but to avoid any loose connection, I will use this PCB. And to connect the LoRa module with the NodeMCU, I have made this small circuit on this zero PCB. These two resistors will act as a voltage divider. Now I can easily connect this LoRa module with the NodeMCU in this manner. But as I said, you can also make this project without using any PCB. Still, if you want to get this PCB, then download the GAVA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with three simple steps. First, upload the GAVA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the PCB. Before uploading the code, I have to configure this to LoRa module with some basic AT command. For that, I will use this FTDI232 USB to serial interface board. And before connecting it with the LoRa module, make sure 3.3 volt is selected. So let me show you. I am placing the jumper with the 3.3 volt. Now you can connect this interface board with the LoRa module as per this circuit diagram. So here you can see I have connected this LoRa module with this interface board, and now I can connect it with the laptop. This is the LoRa AT command guide for the REYAX LoRa module. You can download this document from the video description. Now to update the AT command, first I have to open the Arduino IDE, then go to tools and from here select the proper COM port. After that, click here to open the serial monitor. Now in the serial monitor, make sure you have selected the baud rate 115200, and here you have to select both NL and CR. After that, here you have to type AT, then press enter. You should get this plus OK if the LoRa module is connected with the serial monitor. After that, I will set the address for the transmitter LoRa module with this AT command. And we can set the address from 0265535, but here for the transmitter LoRa module I will set the address 1, and for the receiving LoRa module I will set the address 2. So again, I will go to the serial monitor and type AT plus address equal to 1. You can also check whether the address correctly updated or not with this AT plus address question mark comment, and here you can see in the response I am getting address equal to 1. After that, I will set the network ID. So for the receiving and transmitting in LoRa circuit, the network ID should be same. In this case, I will set the network ID 5. So let me type AT plus network ID equal to 5. After that, you have to select the band for the LoRa module. For that, first you have to search for the band which are allowed for the LoRa module in your country. So you have to select the band as per your country. Here I am selecting the band 865 MHz. For that, I have to type AT plus band equal to 865 000 000, which is 865 MHz, then press enter. Now in the similar way, I will connect the receiving end LoRa module with the laptop. After connecting the receiving LoRa module, go to tools, select the proper COM port, then open the serial monitor. Again type AT, you should get this plus OK response. Then set the address. For the receiving end, I am setting the address 2. So let me type AT plus address equal to 2. Then I will set the network ID. So I will type AT plus network ID equal to 5. As I said, the network ID and the band should be same for the transmitting end and the receiving end for LoRa module. Then I will set the band as 865 MHz. So let me type 80 plus band equal to 865 000000. So after configuring these three parameter, I can disconnect the LoRa module. These are the codes for this project. For the transmitter circuit, you have to upload this code to Arduino, and for the receiving end circuit, you have to upload this code to NodeMCU. First, let me explain the code for the transmitter circuit. So first, you can see in the board setup, I have defined the input output pin and also set the baud rate to 115200. Then if I go to void loop, in the void loop you can see if I press the first push button, then this if block will execute. Here we are sending this to receiving end LoRa module. This is the syntax for sending data to another LoRa module. So the AT command is AT send. Then this is the address of the receiving end LoRa module. This is the payload. And this is the string that we want to send. So if I press the first button, then receiving end LoRa module will receive this R1 as a string. After that, it will call this get feedback function. As a feedback, if everything is fine, we should get this FR1 string. So if I go to this get feedback function, here you can see first we are turning off the red and green LED. Then we are checking if any data available in the serial terminal, then we are reading that data and comparing with the expected string, which is FR1 for the relay 1. So if you get that string, then the state will be true and we are coming out from this loop. Otherwise we will check for a certain time. So if we get the correct feedback, then the state will be true and we'll turn on the green LED and turn off the yellow and red LED. But if you don't receive any feedback, then we'll turn off the green LED and turn on the red LED. So this is the code I will upload to Arduino, which is connected with the transmitter in LoRa circuit. Now let me explain the code for the receiving end LoRa module. You can upload this code to any microcontroller. In this case, I have used NodeMCU. So in the void setup, again I have set the baud rate to 115200, and in the void loop I am calling this LoRa control function. In this function we are checking if the data available in the serial terminal, then we are reading that data. And after that, we are comparing that data with the predefined value. If we receive R1 in the serial terminal, then we are toggling the state of the relay and send the feedback to transmitter circuit. After uploading the code, I can connect these two LoRa module with the transmitter and the receiving end LoRa circuit. First, let me connect the LoRa module with the transmitter end LoRa circuit. And I have given the 5 volt supply from my mobile charger, but you can also use a 9 volt battery instead of mobile charger. And for the receiving end, I have made this PCB to connect the LoRa module with the NodeMCU. So first let me connect the LoRa module with this PCB. After that, first you have to give the 5 volt supply to NodeMCU. Here I am using a mobile charger again. So after giving the 5 volt supply, you can connect this LoRa module with the NodeMCU. Otherwise the booting process may fail. So let me connect it with the NodeMCU. So our transmitting end and the receiving end LoRa circuit is complete. Here you can see I have connected these lamps with the relay module. Now if I press the first button in the transmitter circuit, the yellow LED start blinking, lamp turns on. And after receiving the feedback, this green LED turns on. Now to turn off this lamp, I have to press the first button again, and again the LED start blinking, lamp turns off, and it received the feedback. And in upcoming video, I will try to add more features in this circuit. So if you like this project, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And to get the notification for the upcoming video, please do subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.